Hello, hi, and welcome to yet another episode of Candid with Candida. Today I have with me two of the most loved Goan musicians who were once based in Delhi but currently in Goa. They were a part and is a part of a band called Black Slades. One such legendary guitarist who is a legend in Goa, a bass guitarist, Anthony Braganza, popularly known as Anton. Yep, and a warm welcome.
Thank you so much for inviting me.
And along with him is yet another lead vocalist of the same band, Ronald Da Silva.
Hi.
Welcome.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm fine, thanks. How are you
doing? How are you, Anthony?
You're all good, yes, lovely.
Okay.
Yeah.
Nice. How are things going on?
Yeah, all awesome, all good, great.
Okay,
yeah.
All right. Let's quickly start with the conversation. Black Slades. Why Black Slades?
It's been... the name is... it has a meaning, okay? Mm. Slate means like it's an artist, mm-hmm. but a black slate is like a darker side of a valley. It was mm-hmm. in, if you go to find, in a decision, you'd find mm-hmm. the dark side of the valley is called black slate. Mm-hmm.
33 years of experience yeah.
In Delhi, yes, yes.
As a bass yeah. guitarist.
Yeah.
So, tell me your experience.
Yes, well, I've been, in 1991, I joined Black Slate. Mm-hmm. We formed Black Slate there in Delhi, the mm-hmm. second part of. First Black Slate was in Goa for 4-5 years, I think so. That's a different setup. Mm. From 1989 to 90, there was no Black Slade dispute, and they joined some other person in the hotel industry in Delhi. In 91, I joined them, and we kept the same name as Black Slade. Mm. Our keyboard player, Benny, said, since we'll use the same name as Black Slade. This is the second part.
Okay.
So second part, till then, we did till 2013-14, like that. Mm. So some of the members left. Benny is gone to UK. Mm-hmm. So the other two boys, the drummer, and they are gone separate. Ronald also was part of me. Mm-hmm. He joined 2001, I think so.
Okay.
And before that, Norman was a singer. But we did well. We were one of the most, I think so, most happening band in India today. Mm-hmm. Whatever, last 33 years, you can say, mm-hmm. we're still rocking.
Okay, yeah. Good. Ronald,
yeah.
Tell me your story.
Music, as a musician, I've always been blessed by this talent, you know, to be singing, you know. But I started my musical career at the age of 16 and in Goa, did my schooling, college, everything here. Mm-hmm. So I started off my musical career as a trio. Then I formed a band of my own. Then I found joined another prominent band in the south. Mm-hmm. Until I got an opportunity to go to Delhi to perform, and then, you know, as luck had it, my thing, I got a chance to join Black Slade, and now it's history, you know.
Okay.
You know, it's been a great journey all this while. It's been fantastic.
Okay, tell me something. It's never a fixed place for a, you know, a lead vocalist or maybe a bass guitarist at one particular band. It's always like you all are rolling for some band or the other.
How yes, yes. I've been backing up a lot of other artists also. What to do? We have to do that. Mm-hmm. We had played with, a lot of Indian top artists, whoever it is. I back them up, do something like that. And then at the same time, I like jazz or something, so I have a different setup for jazz also. Mm-hmm. I represent India for International Jazz Festival.
Okay.
So now third next year in March we are going to do the third, I think so.
Okay, what about you?
Yeah. I mean, I would say Black Slade has always been a fixed setup, you know, but then we'd always have artists who would like to collaborate with us and jam with us, and we were open to that. So I would say we are one of the only bands in Goa, probably since we all Goans, based out of Delhi, but we'd be one of the only bands that would actually want to collaborate with other artists, you know. And it's a fantastic thing. Why? Because you learn a lot from others, you know. So I think it's a good, It's a good way of learning something new every time, you know.
Okay. Since I'm getting a positive vibe looking at your outfits, can you just hum two lines for us of any of your songs which has been your favorite?
So in terms of music, I don't have a particular favorite, but I love all kinds of music, you know. It depends on my mood at that point of time.
So currently, what is your mood?
Currently, there's a jazzy song that's coming to my mind, a song which is more original by Frank Sinatra, and then a lot of other artists, big artists have done it. A song called Fly Me to the Moon, you know.
Okay.
Fly me to the moon and let me play among the stars. Mm-hmm. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars.
Okay.
In other words, hold my hands. In other words, darling, kiss me. I think we should stop at that only now.
Oh, wow. Very nice one. Thanks. Anthony, tell me, it's been like, you know, you travel, you leave Goa, like you leave your birthplace and then you travel Delhi. And then after a long gap, you'll come back. What is the thing, like your bonding? What has been?
Because of work, you can say, and the shows, whatever. In Goa, there are so many bands, so many things happening. And usually, we don't play for weddings. We are not a wedding bands. Mm. We usually do corporate shows, all those type of things. Mm. And that's why I have to do corporate shows. I go to Bombay, Delhi, some other part of states. Mm. So, and plus, rich weddings, some posh, you know, special big weddings, mm. or those type of things. And Goa, we were focusing more of beach shows and dances. Mm. But that culture is dying.
Correct.
Today. And everything, only this year we had Welsam beach show, we had a massive mm. crowd.
Okay.
That is what I love to, you know, to perform for. We are more of a concert band.
Mm-hmm.
We like to play with showmanship, action, everything. We, you know, that is the thing.
You've also done tracks with Kailash K.
Yeah, all those guys. Before, they're part of them beginning journey. Mm-hmm. All this guy, KK, Kailash K. A lot of guys, they made a big name.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So
right.
They are started, you know, my journey is different, their journey is different. It's like, you know, like a lot of guys, more than 100 singers, mm-hmm. there, you know, who sang with me, with my band, all mm-hmm. of us. But few of them, maybe it's like a lottery for them, they made it big.
Okay.
So it's a luck for them, you know. Some guy never made it happen.
Mm-hmm.
Some guy is still in Bombay trying their, you know, the best, but it's mm-hmm. not working out for them.
Okay. Ronald, what do you do besides music?
Up till the time I was in Delhi, I just did music, you know. Mm-hmm. And sadly, at that point of time when I moved from Goa to Delhi, music wasn't paying in Goa, you know.
Okay.
And unfortunately,
correct.
It's a very sad thing to say, but mm-hmm. It wasn't, you know. That was the fact about it, mm-hmm. you know. But when I moved to Delhi, the exposure was so immense, and you know, I did just music, you know. And as Blackslade, we did just that, you know. We traveled a lot, we did a lot of good stuff, mm-hmm. and it was only music. But now, it's been 3 years now since I've moved back home to Goa, for good now.
Mm-hmm.
And on the side, I'm handling my family business.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah, so, but I still do music. I mean, because that's a part of me. You know, it's a.
Do you
part
have
of
your
my
any
being.
Originals with you? Like, do you
I've got stuff written down, but never put them to, you know, as in like on record and stuff like that. But yeah, I do have a couple of stuff written down. Hopefully, when the time is right,
mm-hmm.
and you know, it will. Fall
okay.
in place.
Anthony, tell me something. Did you always dream of being a musician, or did it happen by fluke?
Yes, I think so. I was dreaming to become a musician first. Mm-hmm. I had when I at the early age. So we were the choir, you know, musicians
uh-huh.
singing in the choir,
okay.
playing. I used to play a little keyboard also mm-hmm. church. Then I joined the Kala Academy School,
uh-huh.
2-room upright bass, double
okay.
bass. But then I could not afford to buy a double bass. That time you could not buy. Mm. Then I tried to join. To learn piano. But mm. I didn't have piano. They didn't allow me to
okay.
learn piano. But I had dream to. But everything changed when I went to Delhi. It was different.
So you always wanted to be a musician.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay. What
but
about
then
you?
Once I went to Delhi, you know, everything mm. changed for mm. me. In Goa, it was a hobby. I would have been playing like, and I would have been doing some other job mm. or working somewhere and playing music as a hobby mm-hmm. or something. Like a lot of yeah.
Mm.
So a lot of in Goan boys, they do work and they are not full time musician, but they decided. But this is the thing.
What is the current scenario that you notice when it comes to band Goan bands?
They are doing. They are good. They are set. Everything. They are all of them are good bands. All a lot of
anything
good,
is there that has to be
good. There,
amazing.
But only sometimes, yeah, they are good. But
the
they
exposure.
Have to go. You know, they are like some of them stuck
mm-hmm.
themselves only
over there.
Yeah, like Frog in the Well,
mm-hmm.
they only. They should go out and see
mm-hmm.
the talent. What they are. If they are really good, they should go out and play everywhere.
Is the music industry blooming? You'll see.
Yes,
in
of
Goa
course.
Now at
mm-hmm.
the moment,
yeah.
yes, I would
right.
say because. I think Goa has come on the map, although
yeah,
it was, but in terms of being a tourist destination, it's become more
mm-hmm.
Open to the wider market, mainly domestic plus international.
Mm-hmm.
Today, I think the music industry in Goa is picking up.
And
like for example,
all the corporate
shows, those Delhi corporates, Bombay corporates, they are all it's been held here in
mm-hmm.
Goa. Taj, you know, all these places,
mm-hmm.
most of the Lila and all the they are taking place here in Goa nowadays.
Mm-hmm.
It's become such a destination that everyone wants to do something or the other in Goa.
What about originals? Don't you all think that the band has to come up with some original tracks of theirs rather than focusing on the old versions or something?
Yeah, original also, yes, of course. Today's a lot of bands are doing original. Original also is good, but in India, they prefer more of Hindi.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So we as a Goan, we have a little problem as a diction problem pronouncing. So that's why our Hindi is not good.
Mm-hmm.
So and Western doesn't sell much.
Mm-hmm.
We have our own English. We have all the, we compose all the English songs, everything. But doesn't sell. Nobody want to promote you. Mm-hmm. You have to spend whatever you are saving. You have to spend on that
mm-hmm.
recording all that. But if you are doing Hindi, is good. But I think so. The Goan, you know, musicians, mm-hmm. whoever it is, our diction is a problem.
So
Hindi, what you pronounce Hindi, what you talk is different. And when Delhi, Delhi boys, how they mm-hmm. sing and they pronounce is different.
Mm-hmm.
They are not great singers also, but they in the Hindi is different. Mm-hmm. That's how you actually.
So do you still have a collection of bass guitars with you?
Yeah, I have quite a lot. Yeah.
Okay. Tell me something, Ronald. When did your career start in music? Did you always want to be a musician?
So whenever people ask me this, I always say God created me to do music. You know?
Huh.
I mean, like ever since I remember as a kid, even in my kindergarten, my school, I was the first person to take part for a singing competition. You know,
mm-hmm.
and it has always been there that mm-hmm. way. You know, mm-hmm. so I say yes, I was created to be a mm-hmm. musician. You know,
mm-hmm.
although I'm qualified to be something else on paper, but I'm created to be a musician.
Okay, wow. Okay, your family support, were they supporting you?
Yes, yeah, beginning of course, but then later on when, you know, once I finished my, I did my graduation in BCom, so mm-hmm. after that, everyone forced me to, you know, take a proper job, everything. Music, there was not much.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, the scene in Goa also, there's no much, I mean, that not much money is there. In Delhi also, you have to need to, if your band is doing well, then it's fine.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, there's, you know, you can't depend on music.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah. What is your range of band like? What songs do you all perform? Is it according to the audience?
We are versatile. I think so.
Oh,
yeah.
With us, mainly as Blackslade, we are very versatile band. We cover anything and everything from in any kind of music. You know,
mm-hmm.
for us, music has never been a barrier. Like, oh, we should only stick to one genre.
Mm-hmm.
We've always done anything and everything. You know. And we basically go by how the crowd is, you know.
Okay.
We love doing a certain type of music, but then we'd still cater to our mm-hmm. audience, you know.
Right.
And that's why we've been loved so much, you know, in Goa and everywhere we've gone, you know, we performed, you know.
Mm-hmm. And you seem to have different kinds of skills to perform on your bass guitar. When the bass is with you, obviously we'll have a look now, but then still the tricks, the mood, how does it happen?
I don't know how it came, because me and Benny, you know, a keyboard player, when we are... I think so. It's like action, showmanship. Our actions are a little completely different.
Does showmanship matter?
Of course, yes. It's part of all the thing.
Mm-hmm.
But I think so. It came natural because I was a follower of a lot of top. I mean, like, you know, I have a, like, who can say, inspired by some lot of big artists like Iron Maiden, you know, mm-hmm. bass player. So a lot of guys who are action. So when we were young, we were looking at them.
Mm-hmm.
Another bass player like Jaco Pastorius, I still listen to him. So all the, you know, it's like that was a this
okay
and well, then suddenly it becomes part of your, you know, it's part of you. I don't know what I'm doing, but it becomes part of your performance style.
Yeah, so basically showmanship shouldn't
come
be
natural,
forced.
Yeah, it's come
when you're on stage. You shouldn't
be natural.
It should come naturally. I mean, when you enjoy what you're doing, it comes naturally, you know.
Yes,
it comes that way, you know. So
yeah, music is, see, a lot of whilst performing, you know, it has to be, you know, you should enjoy your mm-hmm. performance also. You have to enjoy with the crowd. You have to, you know, everything.
Mm-hmm.
Some guys are just playing, you are sick of playing, and give
me
money. Okay, then guys will say, okay, give me money, I'm going. Some guys, musicians, they come and play with me. Okay, they wait for time also. What time we'll finish the show? Okay, what time we'll go? And they go.
Mm-hmm.
There's nothing.
Mm-hmm. Correct.
See, my music was different. My music was not for money. I was for, you know, fully focused on, you know, for my what I do.
Mm-hmm.
You know, my subject and mm-hmm. I sacrificed my life for this.
Mm-hmm.
I have not done any other work. I never worked in my life.
Right.
I only played bass guitar and nothing.
Okay.
Never done anything. Nothing.
God has been kind, actually.
What have been your challenges so far?
Yeah, challenge. Yes, of
never?
Course.
See, challenges. Mm-hmm. Firstly, if you'd ask me, when I first moved to Delhi, leaving Goa and going to Delhi, And when I moved to Delhi, I was a teenager.
Okay.
You know, so leaving Goa and going to a totally new state.
Mm-hmm.
You know, completely new state. It's first thing, what your challenge would be a culture shock, you know. Mm-hmm. Delhi being a totally different place, you know. The way you leave your parents behind, you leave your whole family behind, you leave everything behind mainly. Mm-hmm. And then you start anew in another state altogether, you know. Luckily for me, God was great. We had a great team, you know. The whole team that we were together with Black Slade, that was one team that actually, you know, helped you forget certain things. But you know, a lot of challenges again, your Hindi, you know, your diction. I mean, in Delhi, although I studied Hindi in school, but then when I left to Delhi and I'd speak to people in Delhi, they know I'm not a Delhiite because of the diction. It catches on that, you know. So that again another challenge, you know. And then thirdly. Before I joined Black Slade, Black Slade was a big name anyways, you know, but then it was a challenge of keeping up to that name, and by God's grace, I think I pulled through, you know.
All right, okay. Last but not the least, my last question to you all. What are you all doing currently? Are there any projects lined up? Or what?
Yeah, of course.
We've got
a lot of projects lined up.
We've got a lot of shows lined up.
We are trying to visit a lot of... places like Shillong, Guwahati,
there's
a nice, you know, other the places where the real music is there. Sometimes you feel like playing all the this, like Shillong, some other places. It's like Goa, what was Goa 10, 15, 20 years back?
Maybe not 20 years back, it would be 30, 40 years back.
Rocking.
You know, so the northeastern part of India is still very amazing in terms of music, you know, they still listen to great stuff, you know, and they respect musicians mainly, you know, that's one thing, you know. So this is what Goa was in the good old days, you know, although money was not there, but I think the respect for musicians was still there, you know. So we've got projects lined up there where we've got shows, we'll be traveling and all.
All the very best for your future.
Yes. Thank you. Good luck.
And now, since you all have spoken a lot, let's have a quick jam up session. Are you all ready for it?
Yeah, okay.
We can.
All right, rapid fire round with Amsobab Anton. Ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Which instrument did you play in high school?
Piano, I think.
Okay. Describe your favorite venue of performing.
My favorite venue.
Venues.
Yeah. I think so. Goa University, Delhi University.
Okay. What's your least favorite beverage?
Beer, you can say.
What's the worst thing you've ever eaten in a restaurant?
Lately, I was performing for Congo in embassy. I have a caterpillar.
Okay.
And
how did it taste?
It was tasting normal. They can't make it.
How is...
It's African.
Okay. When you play, you look like Dash. Complete the following.
Maybe I
you look
have to
like
come. Yeah. Maybe you can say Michael Jackson.
What's the first thing you would do if you become invisible?
That's a tough one.
What would you do?
I'll go eat and something, okay. Maybe a lot of food wherever I get something just to.
Say a word in Spanish.
Hola.
What does it mean?
Hello, hi.
Why can't we tickle ourselves?
Tickle?
Yes. Why can't we tickle ourselves?
Tickle ourselves. No, we can't tickle ourselves. No, we always tickle ourselves.
Do you believe in love at first sight?
Yes, of course.
Have you ever slapped someone in the face?
Someone, maybe sometimes.
Okay. All right.
Because
climb.
Someone irritated me before.
Climb a mountain or jump from a plane?
Climb a mountain.
Have you ever been to Africa?
No.
Do you have any friends taller than?
Yeah, of course. Lot of friends.
Tell me what you like to do on weekends.
I party.
Okay. Well done, Anthony.
Okay.
All right, moving on to Ronald. Are you ready?
Yep.
Okay. What's the most boring thing ever?
What's the most boring thing ever? Not having music.
What do you like most about playing music?
Connecting with my audience.
What would you do if you made a mistake during a performance?
It's okay.
What would you do if your audience looked tired?
You learn from it, basically, you know. Okay. That's why I said, if you make a mistake, you learn from it and go carry on.
What would you do if your audience looked tired or bored during your performance?
That's okay, I'm always filled with energy.
Do you prefer being called a nickname?
I don't mind it, yeah. I've got a nickname.
So what would it be?
Bobo. So people know me as Bobo, actually.
Okay.
So.
Who is the one person that knows you best?
I think my mom, my parents, my family.
Okay. How many words can you type per minute?
Per minute? I've never tried typing, but then I don't know, maybe around 10, 15 words maybe.
Okay. What's your favorite social media app?
I'm not a very social media person, but now because of music, yeah, maybe Insta, I think, is the right app to be
What's
on.
What's the earliest memory you can remember?
Earliest? I think school. When I was in school, I took part for a Kuridin competition.
Why do you remember it?
Just because I was made to, I mean, like, it's a boys' school and my classmate was dressed as a girl and I was as a guy. So, I mean, it was, as a kid, it's something you remember.
Okay, flip-flops or sneakers?
I'm a sneaker kind of guy.
Where did you grow up?
I grew up in Binaulim.
Is your hometown famous for anything?
Yeah, Binaulim. I think Binaulim is famous for what now? I think Binaulim is famous for what? I think Binaulim is famous for something. I don't remember.
What's your favorite animal?
Dog. I'm a dog person.
What item have you carried from childhood to adulthood?
Item or as in a physical item?
A toy or anything that you have still now with you. Do you have something?
I do, but nothing is coming at the...
Do you have any childhood habit? That is still carried
habit?
On. Yeah.
Yeah, of course. I mean, like, singing is my childhood habit.
Okay, what holds you back?
I think people who are negative.
All right. Well done and well answered.
Thank you.
It was very quick. So now we are moving on with our final round, and that is called as Read My Lips. So are you all ready?
Yours or whose?
Each other's.
Okay.
Ready?
Okay, cool. Yeah, why not? Yeah.
Read My Lips with Anthony and Roland. Are you all ready?
I can't
he is ready.
Hear anything.
Okay.
Take one.
Yeah.
Okay, read it. You have 30 seconds. Mm. Wait. Mm. Your time starts now. See.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. No.
You have to say it.
Say it? Yeah. Limbu soda.
Slowly only. You cannot scream. Yeah.
Say
limbu soda.
You can make actions. Or
limbu soda. Limbu soda.
Yes. Did you get it? You heard
Did
it?
Did he say limbu soda?
Yes.
I just said, I saw his mouth saying limbu soda. I didn't hear him. I can't hear. Oh, nice. Yeah. Fantastic. Yeah. Good.
Okay. The other one.
I think,
The other one.
Okay.
Your time starts. Now,
rock the party.
Rock, slowly.
Rock the party.
Again.
Yeah. Rock the party.
Again.
Rock the party.
Country party.
No, you are still close by.
Yeah. Huh?
No, you have to put it on.
Rock the party. Rock the party.
You just have 30 seconds.
Dog.
No. Party. Second right, first rock the party. Yeah,
okay. Okay. It's rock the party.
Oh, rock
you
the
go
party.
Got it actually. Yeah, you so how anything
you were
can
close by.
Oh,
it was no, supposed to be rock the party. You got a second, the party you got.
Okay, last chance. Ready?
I can do action also?
Yes, you can. Your time starts now.
Check my lips.
Read my lips.
No, you are just close.
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 Yeah. Check my lips.
Say again.
Check my lips.
Suck my lips.
Oh my God.
Save. Check my lips.
Lips, I know, but what's the first?
Check my lips.
Say again.
Check my lips.
It's check my lips.
Oh, check my lips. I thought it was suck my lips.
okay.
He wasn't close. Everything was close.
All right. Okay.
Now
we'll switch. Ready?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Your time starts now.
Three words.
I bought my three. I bought my. I'm not getting it. I bought my. You about to dance?
No, it's hip-hop dance.
Hip-hop dance.
Hip-hop dance. Oh, hip-hop dance.
Okay, you still have two more chances.
I think I got one. No? Oh, okay. Ready?
Yes, your time starts now.
Okay.
What is that? Action. I'm going to fly.
You wanted action, I showed you action.
I'm going on the. I'm traveling. I'm going.
Okay, tell him.
Going to Ibiza.
Ibiza, yes, I'm going to Ibiza.
All right, last one.
Okay.
Action.
Start.
I'm in the hole. Going down. Going round and round. Going a circle.
Smart city.
Now going around. I'm in the pothole. In the pothole. I'm traveling. I'm traveling in a pothole. going up and down a pothole. pothole on the road. Side. On the road. Okay.
Right.
I got it actually. Pothole on the road. Oh, yeah, Michael.
All right. Well played, guys. And you won, Roland.
Oh,
and for this, I have a small token of appreciation from the Team Prudent. This is for you, Anthony, and this is for you. Thank you so much for watching this episode, Candid with Canada. Hi karavol pore tolang tumka soglang dio pore koru. Pore trawat Prudent Media chair, Candid
with Canada.
हॅलो टोटल अजूनपर्यंत 15 भुरगी शेणल्या सर. हय सर, चडशी 7 ते 10 वर्सां. आ शाळेंत सोडल्या तुमी?
शाळेन चे शाळा आसतना ती वचना साहेब.
आनी आतां तर सुटी पडल्या. तुमी आनी कितें साहेब?
सर सुटी पडल्या आतां. तुमी आनी कितें सर? ना सॉरी सर, सॉरी सर, ना. हय तुमी म्हणटाले हांव वचून पळयतां आतां. कितली बरी शाळा.
Ha!
चोरानो म्हजेकडे खेळटा गोवा पोलिसाकडे.
सॉरी काका.
सॉरी सॉरी बी काय ना, खंय आसा ती बाकीची भुरगी? चला या आता घरा. अरे भुरगीं पयलीं शाळेन वचपाक रडटालीं, आतां घरा वचपाक रडटा, हो कसलो रे चमत्कार?
चमत्कार न्ही, आमचो गोंय सरकार.
अरे गांवान गांवान जर अश्यो सुंदर शाळा जाल्यो जाल्यार भुरग्यांच्या शिक्षणा बद्दल भिवपाची गरज ना.
भिवपाची तूं, आतां आमकां घरा वचपाची गरज ना.
नव्या तमाचे सेर उतराचे हे आमचे सरकार, प्रभुसवंताच्या खाला सपना जाता साकार. नव्या तमाचे सेर उतराचे हे आमचे सरकार, प्रभुसवंताच्या खाला सपना जाता साकार. गोयाचो फुलारे फुडार खोशी आसा रे गोयकार, युपाची काय गरज ना.
दरेक गोंयकाराचो आधार डॉक्टर प्रमोद सावंताचें गोंय सरकार.